This is going to be really funny.
Yes.
Hi, guys.
And here we are. Here we are, live.
Greetings and salutations.
Here we are live at PAX. It's awesome.
Live from the show floor in Boston, Massachusetts.
It's
here at PAX
Saturday night. No, it's not.
It is Friday afternoon here at the Funcom booth for Conan Exiles.
Hey, guys. My name's Insanic.
My name is Andy Bennett.
And we're your community managers. Andy, you're a little bit, I think you should... scoot over to my side a little bit.
Okay.
Getting close. Getting nice
okay,
and close.
Okay, great. Fabulous.
Yeah,
great.
All right.
Oh, boy. We're just so close over here.
So, PAX.
Yes.
What up, PAX?
What's up, everybody? Whoa!
But
I'm the worst at this. I'm sorry.
That's fine. It's fine. I don't think the people in the booth are hearing us. Hopefully, people on the stream
Perfect.
Are hearing us.
Fabulous.
Hopefully, people on the stream are hearing us.
Puberty.
If not, let us know in the chat.
Puberty is hard. I apologize.
Yeah.
So how you been, man?
I'm doing all right,
it's
man.
It's crazy. This
it's
is crazy
wild,
stuff.
It has been a wild few days.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
A lot of last-minute booth setup. I'm really glad that everything seems to be going pretty well right now.
Yeah.
We have a whole crowd of people here seem to enjoy themselves playing Conan Exiles on the show floor.
Yeah, it's really cool. Just like we knew the game was popular already because it sold a bunch of copies, but I had no idea it was going to be as crowded as it ended up becoming for us, which is really, really awesome.
Yeah, I am pretty pumped to see this kind of turnout. It's really cool.
Yeah. But I noticed that we maybe should have had headphones in so we could hear each other, because over the din of the con, it's a bit difficult.
Yeah,
but
yeah. Please let it, yeah, chat,
we'll
please
just,
let us know if the if sound kind of sounds funky, and or I understand if my voice sounds terrible.
That's fine.
Understand. I've been yelling.
Both of us have been talking and yelling throughout the entire day, and then suddenly we're going to be talking and yelling so much more. It's only the first day, but
Let's see.
Been a hell of a ride. It's been a hell of a ride.
People are trickling in on
this
chat
is your first
right
PAX, right?
This is my first PAX, indeed. Yeah, this is my first time having to work or getting the opportunity to work a pretty big convention like this.
Sure.
It's super exciting. I'm honored to be here.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you to our illustrious staff at Funcom for allowing me to make a fool of myself in front of everyone here and online. And in front of people here who are all
of course.
Busy playing the game anyway. They're not
Come
paying
on,
attention.
You haven't made such a great fool of yourself.
Sound? The sound? All right, sound is good? Okay, cool.
Sound is good? All right. Like, from what I understand, you haven't made such
here.
A big fool of yourself.
No,
yet.
Except when I was trying to be like, what's up, everybody?
Yeah, you've done some poses and stuff for people on pictures.
Yeah, yeah.
But, like, you don't look like a crazy person when you take a picture with you and a very famous streamer like I did.
Nice.
I look like a crazy person. Mathematic, he's a role player. He stopped by the booth. Awesome dude. Very nice mustache. And
nice.
I took a selfie with him, and then I looked at the pictures afterwards, and I looked like a complete crazy person. It was wonderful.
But you are a crazy person. We're both
slightly.
You just have to be crazy when you're doing PR work, man. This
I
is
mean,
just how it works.
There should be like a plaque when you join Funcom that says you don't have to be crazy to work here, but it helps.
We are a bunch of crazy people.
Or like, you don't have to be crazy to work in marketing, but it helps.
You all don't even know how crazy it gets sometimes. You all over on the webcam. Everyone else is intent right here. Intently listening.
But yeah.
Right now. We already did introduce ourselves, chat. I'm Andy Bendit. I'm the community manager for Funcom USA.
My name is Jens-Erik Voller. I'm the community manager for Funcom Norway on Conan Exiles. Well, both of us have been working on Conan Exiles.
Both of us are working on Conan Exiles, and I do work for the Secret World, Age of Conan,
yeah, man.
And Nikki Online as well.
How you do your job... on four games is insane to me.
Some people may have comments about that. I don't know.
Dude,
I'm trying.
I think it's hard running one game.
I'm trying.
I think it's hard running one game. You help out on four games.
That's crazy.
It's
you're a hell of a guy.
You're very kind.
You're like a workhorse. You're a goddamn workhorse.
You're very kind. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I know we're here mostly repping Conan Exiles, but it was actually really cool running into. So far, I've actually run into several TSW players.
Yep.
I think Waldroth came by earlier. Let's see. We had an AO player who has a tattoo of the AO logo on his forearm, and he actually knew Michizude, the lead designer on AO. Yeah. And they used to go to AOCon and do all sorts of stuff. He had a
nice.
Very special message for him.
That's dedication.
Yeah.
That is dedication.
Yeah, getting a tattoo like that, primo stuff, folks.
Like then you know that you really really
you're,
like
you're
the game
committed.
Down to your core.
You're in for life. It's true. And it's this is something I brought up too. Like I this is like. A spiel that I've brought up like with staff here and with other players and stuff like that. But it's when you're working in this kind of role where you're doing a lot of online interactions over the forums and over Twitter and stuff there is that anonymity and the facelessness to it. But when you meet someone face to face and you've the work we've done has touched them or moved them in such a way brought a smile to their face, they get a tattoo of something we did on their body. That's on their
for keeps.
That's crazy.
That's really cool, right? Because the world is crazy. Everything is insane. But right? So everything's on fire. This is fine.
Yeah.
But
no, everything's not on fire. Some things are on fire.
Many things are on fire. Yeah. You're in the USA, everything's on fire. excuse me. So being able to put a smile on someone's face, knowing that you have altered their destiny. That's how I like to put it. The fact that we've altered their destiny and made them happy. It means a lot to me. So it's been really cool to meet some of you guys here today. Really wish I could see all the beautiful faces here over at the Common Exiles booth. Of course, I know a lot of people are over in the EU. Can't make it over here. Can't make it for whatever reason. But thank you for your support.
Hopefully we'll be able to come to other places where people are. Personally, I would love to go to Gamescom and do a big thing there.
Yeah.
Or
Gamescom would be really cool.
Or PAX West or some kind of. Other European-based shows, that'd be really, really awesome.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yeah, there are Europeans here, from what I understand. We met
Such
a Norwegian guy who had just... No, we met a Norwegian guy who had actually just traveled here because of PAX.
Just for the sake of it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's really cool. Nice.
So, he's got more money than I have, personally, to be able to make it here.
Yeah.
Yeah, so what else has been happening? Yeah, we got a lot of YouTubers, streamers stopping by.
Yeah, oh my god.
Saying how much they love the game.
We got to meet Shirley Curry.
Yes,
Curry. For those of you that don't know,
fanboying like a crazy person when Shirley Curry came by. Check out our Twitter feed, it should be on there. There's a lovely picture of myself, Andy, and Shirley Curry, who plays our game. That's really cool.
Yeah, for those that don't know who Shirley Curry is, she is the sweetest woman on earth. She's a senior citizen who is very enthusiastically playing games like various adventure games and has recently gotten into playing Conan Exiles.
Yes.
So she always opens her videos with calling everyone her grandkids and her little boys and stuff like that.
Plays it with her son, I believe.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was really, really fun to see.
She has a big following over at the North Carolina office, and so it was really nice to meet her.
Yeah.
Surprisingly, YouTube icon people.
I mean, she was surprisingly more bloodthirsty than I thought she would be.
Really?
Just a little bit. Yeah, because I told her about some of the features that we're adding to the game, and the trebuchet, for example, and some of the things you could do with the trebuchet.
Yep.
And she had a giant grin on her face, going "Yeah, I like that.
Ooh,
I want
to
do that.
Up.
Yeah,
ooh,
I can blow
yay.
Shit up. I can really do some stuff. It's going to be awesome. So, yeah, she was amazing. She was so lovely, so wonderful. And it's just, because you imagine these people as something else, I guess. But it's really cool to see that, they're just people, I guess. They're
Sorry,
just regular old people doing what they do in the world.
Just kind of doing a little bit of
trying
improv
to make their
right
way.
Now.
Yeah,
that way I don't
have
to take
fine.
My eyes off everything. All right.
We're doing it live.
We are
Everything's
doing it live.
Improvised.
Yeah, this is totally live. We are live from the show floor right now. Things can and very well might go wrong here, so we ask you for your understanding while we work on technical issues. If you're familiar with some of our streams, at least certainly my streams, you know that they're prone to technical issues or other goofy stuff.
Dude, my first stream had no in-game sound.
I know, I'm about to say, at least we have sound, man. I'm sorry.
It's fine. It's fine.
Real quick,
throw
also.
As much shade as you want, Andy. It's fine.
I know.
I have what's coming to me later. I know.
Just real quick from chat, HuntikFan1017 would like to give a shout out to, I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing this, Kintinue.
Kinitinue.
So shout outs to your
shout
out to you from HuntikFan1017. Thank you, man.
That's very
I'm just
lovely.
Gonna move this over here. It's too hard to see.
Oh, this is just it's like as you can see on the stream, we're like there's still people running around and it's coming up on 4 o'clock and there's still a lot of people here. And
yeah,
it's only Friday.
It's crazy.
Like tomorrow
Dude,
when people have
insane.
Time like when people
it's
actually have time
madness,
off.
Yeah.
That's gonna be good.
Hi Marcian. How's it going? Thanks for joining us.
Yeah, you know these people. I don't.
I know. There's like two people from like TSW that are coming
up. Nice.
I'm sure you have your Conan.
I guess.
Exiles
but it's
boys,
like, I guess,
girls.
I guess for an MMO, it's easier to like pick up on usernames and recognize people.
Sure.
Just
right.
Like,
right. Yeah. Because they
and
are.
For
MMOs,
you yourself, like you worked as a GM and you have.
That's correct.
I think you have. And like you've done this for longer than I have, so I think you have like a greater connection to people than maybe what I have.
Well, certainly with our live games right now. Yeah, so a little bit of context. So I was a GM for Anarchy Online AO and TSW, or sorry, AOC and TSW when I first joined Funcom. So I did that for three and a half years. Then I was offered the opportunity to be your community manager.
Yeah,
that's why I'm here in my loud ass sweater.
Today. I love your sweaters, dude.
Thank you.
Your sweaters are tight.
So that certainly like gave me the opportunity to. Kind of build up a repertoire with some of our players, but I mean,
sure.
It's I was still like that faceless guy, you know. Like I had my code name, I still keep it,
right? Of course,
but no one can pronounce it nor spell it, so I just go with Andy now.
Odonoptera.
Yes,
that's what I say.
Very close. Yeah, yeah. I say Odonoptera, but you still said it correctly. I just say it a different way. It's tomatoes, tomatoes.
Right. Okay, right. Sure. Yeah.
But no one knows how to spell it. That used to be my Twitter handle for a bit. Then I went to a presentation thing over at a local college for a Global Game Jam, and I was like. This is my Twitter handle, and everyone just stared at me like, what? So I was like, I'm changing my handle tonight.
Yep.
And I did.
Smart.
So, yeah.
Very smart. Very smart.
Let's see. So, yeah.
I've lost count of how many business cards I've been given by people. I wish I had business cards to hand out, because I feel slightly unprofessional writing my email down on a piece of Post-it and just giving it to people.
Soon.
Yeah.
TM.
Yeah, TM.
We'll get you some business cards.
TM. All right. I think maybe we're going to try to show off some stuff.
Yes. Yeah, we have. We are getting some questions from chat talking about just like what some upcoming new content in Conan Exiles.
Right. Yeah.
Boy, howdy. Let me tell you. We got some coming up.
Just going to jump to that. Hopefully
do that right
this
now.
Work.
Okay.
I'm keeping my fingers crossed. Because like, hopefully it'll work because I'm... We need to wait for 30 seconds for the stream to catch up so we can see if it actually works. We tested it, but like even though we test stuff, it doesn't always work the way we want it to.
Yeah, I understand.
Unfortunately, but we can spend 30 seconds
afterward.
About what we can do. Oh yeah. As I whisper
into your mic.
Yes, exactly. we got it.
Okay.
Awesome. So we're gonna bring in Oscar later, our lead designer.
Cool. Yes.
He's gonna. Talk and hopefully answer some questions, and that'll be good.
Sure.
But for now, we're going to show off some of the work in progress stuff we have, which is, frankly,
cool. Okay,
the
so
weapons.
Yeah, so this is not rolling right now. So we, when it starts, we will shut up, right?
No, when it starts, we're going to have to talk because we're going to explain how it works.
Oh, we're doing.
Or
wait, okay.
No, let's show it, then we talk about it.
All right, yeah, that's great.
Yeah, let's do that.
Let's just do that.
So that's just going to be us like staring at a screen for 2 minutes. We can do some explanations as we go. So this is a trebuchet.
Okay.
Which we're bringing into the game very soon, TM.
I know this is a really hot topic for a lot of people on the forums as
yes.
well, because like a big topic right now, of course, is like how do we do with cliff bases, and that's a really common concern of a lot of players. Believe me, we know.
The trebuchet is a way to deal with some of those pesky mountain bases, and so we want to give players some more like really cool raiding tools and sieging tools. So what you see here is there's a base. For the siege weapons that you then build stuff on.
Right, okay, so there's a foundation and then you build the siege weapon on top of the foundation.
Exactly,
right? Okay.
Yeah. So we're going to be bringing out more stuff than just the trebuchet.
Sure,
there's
going to
be something we call the corpse locker.
Okay.
Which I'm not really sure what is yet. I've seen some sketches of it, but it doesn't really explain what the sketch is, I guess.
So real quick, what did the player just do now, adding more rocks to the trebuchet? How's that
work?
Yeah,
so wait, I can just pause this. The trebuchet works is that you need counterweights for the projectile that you want to throw. And so to throw something further, you need to add more weight to it. So what we saw back at the beginning there, the first time they pulled the lever, and first they cranked it, then they pulled the lever, and they flung the rock, it missed its mark, basically. It didn't hit where it was supposed to hit. And so he went in, he added some more stone, and then hopefully that should make the trebuchet throw something a bit further.
I see.
It's
like a counterweight system?
Yes.
Okay.
And so it then it hit the target.
Cool.
And as far as I know, like in this particular instance, there might be an explosive jar behind the wall. And I'm sorry if my voice is cracking, but
don't worry about it, man.
But we're gonna. I've seen it punch through some stuff before, and it looks really, really cool. In my opinion, at least, and it's a really cool system for maybe taking care of some of those pesky mountains.
I think that'll be really important. Yeah, because like we squashed a bunch of issues that allowed people to get places the way the Winnipeg was. And we'll acknowledge them because that you know the game is in early access. There's going to be issues.
There will be issues. There are issues.
And it's been a huge we know it's been a huge topic on the forums. Every day we go through Reddit and on Steam forums.
And we're
seeing that. So
absolutely.
That's why we're like making sure those things are fixed as soon as possible.
And we're also going to be adding stuff for players to be able to climb all of these places.
Okay. Cool.
It could be like ladders or like something like a grappling hook or stuff like that.
Cool.
So. You're going to be able to knock them down, but you're also going to be able to go up there and like kill people in their sleep.
Cool. Rating's what people like to do,
exactly,
man. That's what you do in Conan Exiles, man.
That is the thing in Conan Exiles. Next up is our upcoming die system,
which
a lot of role players have been really looking forward to.
And not only just role players too, but I think a common bit of feedback that we get is like it's kind of hard to tell who's on what team, kind of like in fights and stuff like that. So like if like for example, we can talk about this like while we roll the tape or whatever. But we have the regular kind of like normal looking, what is that, medium armor? Yeah.
That is just a regular character in the medium armor and with vanity cam turned on.
Okay.
So the way the die system works is really easy. You just take off the armor you need, you click it, hit more, hit die, and then you have the various color channels.
Cool.
So you just click the channels, mm-hmm. and then you click the die or the color that you want on said channel, and then just skip it back a little bit, and then you just hit the place where it says die all, and that should work everything out.
Cool.
And just apply die, and then everything should work. And of course, the way we want to do it is we're going to tie this into the crafting system, so you're going to be gathering stuff out in the world. Mm-hmm. To be able to color all these things. So
just like in real life, you would take their existing materials in real life.
Yeah.
Will they be like rare colors out in the world?
You're gonna have to ask Oscar
about
that one.
Okay,
I'm not privy to that information just yet.
I'm like the one interviewing you here because this is all kind of new to me too.
Sure. It's actually fairly new for me as well.
Oh yeah, alright, cool.
But the plan is to have like everything be able to like be dyeable.
Cool.
Is that the word? Dyeable?
Dyeable, sure.
Yeah, you're supposed to be able to dye all the in-game items. All
right, awesome.
Like there are various like not everything has all the color channels.
Sure.
You can see the dancer's outfit only has the three channels
rather than the four channels. Sure.
Our character artist Jenny, who made all of this stuff, is very particular about. She's a perfectionist, basically.
She has standards.
She has very very high standards. So she wants all of it to look as good as humanly possible.
Cool.
And hopefully it will do all that. And she's been working very hard on making all of this, like good enough for the die system.
As soon as the die system comes out, please tell me that there's going to be a nice hot pink and a little bit of blue.
Oh, I wish.
Oh man.
I really wish.
My official colors.
Yeah.
Got to get that scheme going on for
my
characters.
I hope so. Like one of my favorite things to do in video games, and I know it's a very stupid thing. But one of my favorite things to do is whenever I get the option of recoloring something, I always go for like the really like garish, like pink, purple, yellow, all that stuff, just to see how it fits into the world. So, for example, playing the Mad Max game, you get a hot pink color scheme for the car, and it looks really out of touch, but just really incredible. I love it.
Perfect. We have one question from chat also. So is only clothing dyeable, or can you dye weapons as well, or other items?
For now, I think it's only clothing. But Oscar armor? Would know more about that stuff later on.
Good to know.
And hopefully we're not giving too much feedback on the speakers. I hear myself being a little bit metallic, but it should be fine.
Please stream, scream at us if we have any issues. They're still kind of experimenting with this whole thing right now. Again, we're all doing it live right now. We're all very learning. We're here with you. It's like an early access stream. There's going to be issues, and we're working with you to make this the best kind of stream that we possibly can.
Yeah, exactly. I'm really excited about the dye system, cool. especially all the things that people can make. And it's also one of the things that are coming very soon, TM.
Sure.
Because
one of the questions that came up in chat also was the are we going to add the ability to occasionally modify your appearance in the future? So I know we plan on adding, so to answer that sort of from my end, like I know that we are planning on, or we would like to add more character creation options, like more body types, more features, more everything like that. But what can we say about, like, on the fly, once your character is created, will there be any like post character creation, other like things that we can do to ourselves, like,
right,
like, can we change things, like, do we have plans for that, or do we know if we have plans for that, or is that did I just make a suggestion?
That is a question for Oscar.
Okay, right on.
That is a question for Oscar, who will hopefully be here later.
Sure,
he will be here later.
Okay,
we're gonna
great, cool.
So save up those questions and we'll give them to Oscar, and he should be able to answer everything.
So this is also coming up. This is something that we have coming up too. It's a new, sort of like an underground dungeon, right?
Yeah.
As far as I know. Okay, cool.
It's being placed underneath a certain part of the Exile Lands.
Okay.
It's actually the entrance to this place was discovered in, I think, one of the first or second live streams that someone did, like, ever of the game when it was out in early access. And they were trying, like, desperately to open it, like, doing some sort of all kinds of, like, ritual stuff, etc., etc. They were not able to open it.
I see.
And so this is that place, and we have Komodo dragons.
Gross. Yeah.
I'm not going to tell you what kind of place this is, but you can kind of tell what it is still.
Okay.
It's very much an underground, almost underwater type area, and we try to make something that's a bit puzzly and also a bit action-y.
Right on.
So there are certain things that you're going to have to do in this dungeon in order to progress properly. And that involves, like, turning wheels, raising and lower watering levels. It's not going to be as bad as Ocarina of Time and the Water Temple for players who still have nightmares about that thing. But, you're gonna be swimming around for a bit, raising and lowering water level in order to find what you're looking for.
Right on, Ivan.
And, it looks like my laptop is slowly running out of
battery. Yeah, that's fine. Actually, sorry, this is all just like going to be on the fly crap here, because we wanted to do a giveaway for the Barbarian Edition. Yeah, so I think I have it saved on my laptop, so we should be able to get it easily. Sorry, just keep on stalling while I
keep on stalling. So you go through the dungeon,
here.
And of course, this being a proper dungeon,
yep,
it needs a proper end boss.
Okay.
And so you walk through it, you come to this final area,
that.
Very stinky, very smoky, very steamy, and then it rises out of the ground, out of the water,
out of the,
in front of you.
The dank pools. Oh, God. That sounds fun.
I'm very excited to see how people are going to...
Can we expect that kind of special mechanics from this kind of boss as well?
Maybe. That's a question for Oscar, again.
Got it. Cool.
But right, I think it's gonna. I think players are gonna like it. Like, personally,
sweet.
I think the whole, like, the dankness and the stinkiness and the steaminess really like comes through all this stuff. I really like that.
Cool.
Our artists have done a tremendous job getting all this stuff fixed. So it's gonna be good, I think. And I'm just going to move this thing down there.
Yeah, we're just going to move this gigantic thing over here.
Hopefully, we'll be able to...
let's see here. Sorry, I have to...
Are you doing all right?
Yes, I am doing okay. I just got to do one quick thing here.
Slowly, slowly, slowly working through it.
Here. So In addition to having a little live stream here at PAX, we also, as is tradition with a lot of our Funcom streams, we want to do a couple little giveaways.
Yes.
For this episode, we plan on doing this all weekend, all throughout the weekend as well, but we're going to be giving away two Barbarian Edition keys for Conan Exile. So this is the base game plus a huge trove of extras, including like a digital comic book set, a rule book set, or like a digital rule book set, an in-game mount and item and rune
for AOC.
In Age of Conan, as well as 7 days of membership if you don't already have an AOC account.
A t-shirt?
Yes,
which is the thing we're doing, and then
Conan Exiles books. Books, basically. All that stuff. It's actually, could you give me the thing underneath your laptop there?
Yeah.
Yes.
This thing right here.
And the Barbarian Edition is also included this really, really awesome Conan Exiles comic book, which is a prequel to the game itself. And you're going to get it in the as a digital edition, but it looks really, really awesome. We work with Dark Horse to make this happen. And I personally think it's a really cool little story about how Conan came to the Exile Lands and some of the dangers that he met there. And maybe, if we're able, we'll maybe try raffling off one or two of these babies, too.
Oh, yeah. So, yeah, and for those that are interested, yeah, like we can totally just, like, raffle off a couple of these through the stream, and then we'll just, like, mail it to you, like, straight up. If you're comfortable with, like, you giving us, like, your shipping info, like, we will just straight up mail you, like, one of these exclusive Dark Horse comics if you want. So we can throw that
in.
You
might even sign it.
Yeah, have it signed by the devs or something. Oh, we...
Oscar's here.
Okay.
Yeah, Joel should sign them.
If only Joel could be here with us. Oh, okay.
Joel was at GDC and worked his butt off. So,
oh, cool.
All right, you're in. You're back in.
So I'm doing my thing right now. I'm just waiting for folks to kind of chat it up right now. Let's see. Maybe I'll do Moobot. Hold on. I'll do it this way. Sorry. I'm just going to be messing around with technical
stuff.
That's
fine.
This was...
Hopefully I'll be able to stall a little bit. So, yeah, PAX has been incredibly crazy, and we want to thank everyone who came out to see the game.
Yeah.
And to see us, just to say hi, or if you were going to do anything else. If you're coming at another day, we're at booth 13096, and we're open not all hours, but whenever the show floor is open.
Right.
And stop by, say hi. If you're in the area, grab a comic. That'd be really cool. Or just, like, ask us a bunch of questions, really. That's been one of the most fun things for me, at least. Like, having people come and just go, like, oh, yeah, I haven't really heard about this. Tell me about it. And then just, like, rallying off all the sales spiel that I know.
Yeah.
And then just, like, forgetting it halfway through since my brain is kind of cooked. But that's just me.
All right, so I got a live in chat right now. We got the raffle going, so this will be for one Barbarian Edition key, and then right afterward, toward the end of the stream, we will also do one more Barbarian Edition key as well as a giveaway for the
good,
comic.
Good.
That should be good. So let's take some questions from chat right now. Something I noticed the whole bunch pop up in chat right now is, do we plan on adding a, like, sort of a server message of the day system? Or
yes.
Like an Archon thing? Yes. And
yes,
I think
yes, yes,
that's
yes,
a
absolutely.
Very important feature, and
yes.
We know we get it. We get so many questions about it. We are going to do it.
Absolutely.
We don't have an ETA, but we're going to do it.
Yes, absolutely.
So, yes, I hope that helps answer that question.
It's from what I understand, it's being worked on right now.
Cool. That's really good to hear. Awesome.
And yes, because it's been very important for server admins. I know it's been very important
for
role players. And yeah, and if you're the kind of person who wants to build up a community on your server, then it really, really is something that you want.
It was actually really cool, like, meet some, like, we actually had, like, server admins for Conan Exiles, like, come by and be, like, you know, talk about their communities and all that kind of stuff. Like, you know, we had one guy that keeps a pretty full, like, 40, 50-man server, like, going at all times, and he's got a great little community there, which is really awesome. And then we had people, well, you know, we had a few other people come by, which is, like, kind of a smaller, like, more tight-knit community. I know I'm in contact with you know, several server admins, including some of my friends.
Likewise.
My buddies from TSW who are also running their own little server. So I think that's really cool too. So we know a message of the day system is very important. And we hear a lot of feedback from server admins.
If it looks
about
like
that.
I suddenly got distracted, it's because I got distracted by some of the really awesome cosplayers.
You were in fact
walking
distracted,
by.
Yes.
I'm really sorry.
Yeah, no, you're good.
And I think I'm good now. But
okay.
the cosplay stuff.
Everything's just, like, kind of milling
the
around.
The cosplay
right now,
stuff has been amazing to see, and, like, I'm still hoping for, like, a Conan cosplayer to walk by. It's not happened yet, but I really want it to happen. And so if you're at PAX, maybe come dressed as Conan.
Do it. And do it.
Or like Valeria, or like
come,
whoever.
Come dressed as Conan, and then later we might do just like a live presentation kind of thing. But we want to see, or if you can give us a video of like your best war cry.
Yeah,
just
that'd be good.
Just take a video, like something that you would scream. I'm looking off camera here at my PR marketing manager right now. So like, you know, show us your best war cry, something that you would just like charge into combat with, instill the fear of God into their veins. Give us that. We'll give you something special.
The fear of Yogg.
Fear of Yogg. Yes, quite.
Yeah.
So we just ran the raffle. Our friend Jacob Side. Congratulations! You've won yourself a Barbarian Edition key. Golf clap. So if you can please PM the Twitch Funcom account, and if you can give us your email address through that, then we can go ahead and email your Barbarian Edition key once we're back from PAX.
Yes.
So probably around next week, we'll give you a free copy of the Barbarian Edition. So congratulations.
Most of us will be back on like Tuesday, Wednesday-ish, and then we can do anything. So awesome.
Congratulations,
Jacob.
That was
quick. I didn't think it would take I didn't really
technology
is amazing. Wow. Like you got a greater handle on all this Twitch stuff than I do. Like
I haven't done any of this stuff.
Yeah, congratulations. So we're probably gonna do like another raffle later on for another Barbarian Edition key. Maybe also a Conan comic book, because these things are pretty awesome. And we have a lot of them. So my goal...
We have so many of these things.
My goal for this is to just get rid of all of them at PAX. And,
I'm okay with that.
I hope a lot of people will stop by, grab some Conan comics. If maybe you're a streamer or a YouTuber and you want some giveaway swag, comic books. Perfect giveaway swag.
Yeah.
Perfect giveaway swag.
Gosh darn right. A Conan Exiles cosplayer would be completely naked, right? We actually thought about just showing up naked ourselves, but I think we would have gotten kicked out of the convention center really fast, and we're probably just arrested, unfortunately.
You can come wearing a loincloth.
If you so dare. It's actually snowing here, so I wouldn't do that.
It's going to be freezing, but...
Please don't send us nude photos. That's illegal.
Is it?
I'm just going to say it's illegal. I don't want to deal with that.
Oh, it's loud. It's the show floor.
Yeah.
But it's fine.
And so I'm also seeing a couple questions in chat right now that I would love to ask Oscar if we can get him on sometime soon. Hopefully you guys can still hear us because there's an announcer across the way right now. Questions about like weapon balance and all that kind of stuff. We are going to be addressing that. Hopefully we'll be able to give more details as soon as Oscar has a moment to chat and come on stream with us.
He's being interviewed right now, so he's busy doing that, but he'll be here.
Yeah. So Zoslug asks, we're going to be able to get more armors for sorcery-style characters. I don't know if we're going to have like really sorcery, like armor for sorcery, I guess, but I did see some pictures about a new, new outfits that that Jenny is working on.
New outfits
right
and
now.
Clothes are continuously being developed by our character designer, and she really wants like more social clothing and like armors and stuff put into the game. Mm-hmm. So you might not see like big sorcerer's robes, but you'll be able to have enough. You'll be able to have some sort of outfit that you can put your sorcerer into, and he'll look nice and dark and weird and strange. That'd be good, in my opinion. And like even now, some of the priest stuff that you get through the religion system is. Like, it'll make you look, at least the Sedai stuff will make you look sorceress?
Sweet.
Sorcerers. Anyway. And some of the stuff that's being added, like, right now, it looks really, really cool.
Yeah.
I think maybe Oscar's joining us. I think you can walk
around
here. All right,
nice. Yeah, so we have lead designer Oscar coming by in a minute.
I'm going to give Oscar my microphone.
Yes.
And then you can just talk to Oscar.
And we'll just go from there.
And I'll see you guys. Bye, chat.
In a few minutes. Goodbye. So what we have right now, we have the lead designer for Conan Exiles coming on camera right now. We're going to get him set up in just a few seconds. But please feel free to ask questions. I'm going to be taking questions from chat. I'm also going to go head over to the Steam forums right now and see what we can find. Hello, hey. Can you hear yourself when you talk?
I can hear me over there.
Okay. And then if you can hear it through that, then you can we can probably hear you
through
chat.
How's everybody doing?
Cool. So thank you very much for joining us. We really appreciate it. So I guess it's a little bit loud. Give me 1 second just to make sure that sound actually sounds good. So chat, can you give me some feedback on if things sound good right now? Because we got a lot of yelling across the way. It'll take a few minutes, I guess. Well, we can just talk for a little bit right now. So first of all, I think this might be your first time like on stream and like on camera.
It is.
Okay.
I'm terrified.
It's okay.
It'll be fine.
I'm always scared in front of camera anyway. So how about let's start with you introducing yourself to chat and the fans on Twitch.
My name is Oscar Lopez. I'm the lead designer for Conan Exiles. I've been working with Funcom for almost 10 years now. I've been involved in pretty much every single project that Funcom has made since I joined the company.
Oh, wow.
So I was involved in, I joined right after we launched Age of Conan. I worked in a little game back then called Best vs. Monsters. Then I worked in The Secret World. I was part of the Transylvania team in The Secret World. And then worked in LEGO Minifigures Online.
Okay.
And now working in Conan Exiles.
Ooh, that's exciting. Yeah.
That's a lot of stuff.
Yeah, that is a lot. You have quite an extensive pedigree. I much respect you.
I don't know
sir.
About that.
All right, so this is so Oscar here, of course, is the real deal here. He is a direct developer with Conan Exiles. He is more than happy to answer whatever questions you guys want to throw at us.
Yeah, bring it on.
Just keep in mind that like, you know, this is a developer, so please keep them development or like gameplay oriented. So like chat, you know, for example, this would be an opportunity to talk about, you know, if, like, hey, so-and-so server's down, or what are you going to do about these people on this environment, or like, you know, building inside a rock or something like that. So please keep it strictly to like gameplay questions or things that are coming up or things that you're curious about.
Anything related with gameplay, balance of the game, design aspects of the game, why did we do things certain ways? I can help with all those.
Sure. So one good question that comes from Mercantage is in addition to the die system, do we have any plans on making more clear player indicators, such as identifying clanmates versus enemies, for example?
We want to introduce a system where people can basically define their clan colors somehow.
Okay.
So it's not just that you can color any piece of gear however you want. It's
sure.
also you can basically create a template for other people in your clan to use.
Okay.
And then easily apply this to the different pieces.
Cool.
That's not going to come out immediately with the dice system, but it is in our design plan.
Good, good. Let's see. We'll get to some of these questions in a little bit too. Do we have any plans on, hold on 1 sec. In dungeon? About empty chest in dungeon, no reason to do, so what kind of rewards can we expect from the upcoming dungeon?
Come again?
What kind of rewards can we expect from the upcoming dungeon, for example? Or is that something that we're able to talk about?
We don't actually have a full loot table, or even, we don't even know if we want to go with a concept of a classy loot table for this dungeon. But there are unique resources that you can find in there that will allow you to craft unique items.
Okay, cool.
So people will always have a reason to go to this place.
Sure.
And then we need to see what we do with the final boss.
Okay, cool.
That's also going to be interesting lore bits and lore pieces to find.
Sure, yeah, it's good to know. And I think, I guess a really big and a very hot topic that we have a lot of people right now, I'm trying to get a good spot on how we can read these, but I guess I'll just have to turn this way for now. One big and a very hot topic that a lot of people are talking about right now, of course, is the concept of rating and base rating, right? Especially for all our PvPers, it's a core concept of Conan Exiles. As far as like raid balance goes, we know we have the siege weapons coming up. We know that the current avatar system helps with that a little bit, but after we fixed a lot of issues, what can we expect now moving forward on the raid and rating in general?
One of our bigger content sections or content patches that we're working on is not just the trebuchet, right? We are taking a complete look at the siege mechanics in the game. So I'm just going to highlight some of the things that we're trying to do. We want to create multiple tiers of explosives so people don't have to use exploding jars, which are very expensive or should be very expensive, and we will make them expensive.
Someone is saying that, oh, they're a little bit too easy to make right now.
It's a very subjective thing.
Sure,
it can be very easy to get if you're already at that part in the game.
Sure, right.
But that's why we want to make explosives that are easier to get for people that is not there yet. So they also have an option.
Sure, right.
So that's what we're looking at, tiering explosives.
Sure, right.
We are also looking at the mechanics of the trebuchet itself. Like the trebuchet can shoot multiple different types of projectiles, and they have different functions. We are also looking at dealing with verticality in Siege. The game right now seems to be set up in a way where people consider vertical attacks to the bases as a bad thing, and mostly because they got some bad rep because they came out of exploits, right? But vertical attacks on your base should be a thing in the game.
Yeah,
right?
Okay.
Your base should have a roof, and you should have to find ways to get into bases from any angle, right? And
okay.
You have a base, you need to protect it from any angle as well. So we have been talking about how to deal with verticality, how to empower people to be able to climb surfaces or use ladders. Well, we have talked about different options, and not really. We don't really have a final answer on this yet, but we're looking into it.
Sure, yeah. It sounds like a really important topic right now, so I'm sure there's a lot of
chatter going
on. So basically,
vertical rating should be a legitimate way of rating. And we are adding gameplay elements to make that a reality.
Cool.
Right? Another thing that we're looking at is countermeasures for avatars, which is a very hot topic as well.
Yes, they are.
So they are really powerful. We know this. And we are looking at how to approach this problem in an interesting way as well, right? So we have something coming out about that as well. I'm not going to give a lot of details, but we have something coming out not only about how to deal with already existing avatars, but about how to create an interesting environment that leads into avatar wars.
Okay.
Think on it like a Cold War kind of situation, right? It's like, do they have nukes? We have nukes. Should we use nukes?
Oh.
That's the kind of thing that we're looking for to have.
Oh, okay.
Right? So that's basically for Siege.
Got the mind games. Yeah, that's cool.
Yes.
That's cool. That's good.
That
to
makes
know.
It always much more interesting.
Yeah. So thank you for that. I hope that helps answer some of you. I know a lot of you guys' questions about just like what
very
we have planned and what we're talking about internally. I know like we can't always like talk about every little one thing that we're doing like on the forums and stuff like that. So I hope this really helps and pass it around to your friends when we finish the thing up so they can watch the VODs and stuff. another question that popped up was, I think you may have mentioned this to one person earlier, but are there any details or anything else that we can talk about regarding upcoming biomes during early access?
Yes, we can.
Okay.
We are working on a new biome, which is kind of two biomes in one.
Oh.
It's highlands and kind of mountain peaks, or snowy mountains, right? This is going to be located north of the current desert biome. And the highlands will have rivers and green pastures and what you would expect to find in the highlands,
right?
And the snow mountains are going to not only have snow and be like the giant mountain you can climb,
but also
they will be cold. So with this patch, we're introducing the concept of temperature.
Okay.
As you would expect, like in the south of the game, where you're in a desert, then it's very warm and you have to wear something that is light.
Right.
If you are in the snowy mountains, then you have to wear
protective armor that will actually keep
you warm, right?
Interesting.
And of course, with all of this, it's not just the landscape that we have. We also have new cultures and new camps and new pieces of lore and stuff, new gods. It's a pretty big amount of content that we're adding with that.
That sounds really good.
Yep.
So I hope, I saw a picture or a comment about biomes pop up, so I hope that helps answer that as well. Let's see, I'm actually going to go jump over to the Steam forums really quick and see if there's any questions that I can ask here. This is a really technical question. I don't know if you can answer this, but are we planning to upgrade from UE 4.12 to 4.15 plus? I don't know if that's something that we can really... I have no idea what those numbers mean. Okay, right. A new version of Unreal Engine just dropped.
Unreal Engine versions. All right.
Yeah.
I don't think we have plans on upgrading the Unreal version at the moment. It is a much bigger undertaking than in my setup.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
But... maybe later. I don't know. I actually don't know exactly if we're going to update ever or when. So
Sure, yeah. Is there... whatever. Is there anything more that we can talk about with the purge?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, we don't have a lot on the purge. It is in our schedule for this year. It will come, I think it's slotted right now to come after the siege mechanics changes. The idea with the purge is to create a PvE threat to your establishment in the world, right? A lot of the servers are very focused on the PvP conflict and the PvP siege and stuff, but we also support PvE gameplay and PvE servers, right? And in these places, it can feel a bit, it can feel like you need something more.
There. Right.
Something that threatens your base, something that threatens your position of power in the world, right? So the purge is supposed to do this.
Okay.
With the purge, there will be groups of roaming kind of war bands.
Okay.
You initially don't know where these guys are coming from, but it is all connected and tied to the lore and the story of the game.
Uh-huh.
It will all make sense.
Okay.
And these guys will basically appear in some spots in the game, and they will amass their forces, and then they will try to take your stuff, just like players would do.
Sure. Okay.
So that's the idea with the purge. It basically will be kind of PvE NPC raids, I guess you could call it in a way.
Right.
The NPCs you find in the Purge are unique. They're not like the other NPCs you find in the camps.
Right, they're all named or something like that, right? Or no?
There will be legendary name NPCs among them.
Okay,
right?
I see.
Like captains or generals or like thug leaders. Depends on the type of faction. But they also will have unique rewards.
Okay.
If you capture them as trolls, for example, they will have recipes that you cannot get otherwise.
I see, okay.
And so the troll system also connects with this system. This is basically kind of like a new tier or level of trolls and a new field base.
Yeah. Cool. Man, that's a lot. Holy crap.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember when we were first even announcing Conan Exiles. Like, I remember the purge was a feature that we talked about well before.
It was... We've been talking internally about the purge for a long time.
Yeah.
And we're just kind of waiting to find a good way to make it happen.
Good to hear. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Let's see. What do we have time for right now? We still got time for a few more questions. You still got some juice in you?
Yeah,
still
sure. Just bring it on.
Bring it on. All right. So there's another... And I guess this is more like a broader kind of question too, but something that's popping up in chat a couple times, something that we see pop up on the forums and Reddit and sometimes too, is just like general combat, how we're approaching combat and what our plans are about combat as we move forward.
So first of all, we're looking at different types of weapons.
Uh-huh.
We're looking at the weapons that already exist, but also new types of weapons that we want to put in, to try to diversify the options that you have.
Sure.
Right. I'm talking about things like axes are really good against people that wear no armor. Mm. Maces are really good against people that wear heavy armor. And also about things like hammers right now, 200 hammers you can use them to knock people down. Mm-hmm. So we might put in a different type of 200 weapon,
like
a 200 sword, for example,
yeah.
that does something different.
Okay.
Right. So some of these differences are going to be a bit like on the stats RPG side of things.
Uh-huh.
Some of them are more on the purely mechanical, like how do you use this weapon?
Cool,
in combat,
okay.
Right?
Yeah.
What kind of advantage does it give me? So that's on the weapon side of things.
Okay.
We are also just looking at different types of projectiles. We are looking at one of the ideas that we have right now for what would be the tier one explosive is that they're basically hand grenades that you can throw.
Right.
Right.
So okay.
Not only you can use them to attack or raid tier one bases, but also you can use them in combat if you don't have a use for that. And there's also the uses for them. So we're trying to make these kind of low tier explosives useful at all levels of play. So that's basically what we have in plans for combat. There's also the sorcery elements that will come into the game will, of course, change the way combat works or how people approach combat. There's no magic in the game right now, right?
Right.
Things are going to be different.
As soon as sorcery gets implemented, it's
so
going to be crazy.
When people is able to summon undead or people is able to use the dark arts, then combat is going to feel very different.
Sure, yeah.
And we have done a lot of improvements already, and we're still improving the missile mechanics, not only with the bows and the ammunition of bows and crossbows and the difference between the different bows and the different tiers and the bows and the crossbows themselves. but also throwing weapons, improvements on their trajectories and how quick they shoot, how easy it is to use them.
Yeah.
Kind of to open the options, right?
Sure.
We made this throwing axe for the offhand, which was basically supposed to be both, like, to deliver the fantasy of the guy with two axes, but also a finisher weapon that you can throw at someone to try to run away from you, right? And it doesn't really work that way yet, and we're trying to make all these weapons work that way. Like, offer something unique.
That would be something, that would be really cool to have, like, a weapon that, like, you can melee with, but then you can also then throw,
yeah?
Is that the idea? Yeah,
you want to
really
be
cool.
A dual wielding, I don't know, you want to go, like, sword and dagger?
I know, I do. I want to do double axes.
Go for it, right? And then the guy's running away, you can throw the axe, right? We have talked about every different weapon internally and what we're going to add to each one of them to make them all feel different and have different use cases, basically.
Good to know. Thank you. Let's see. I saw this. I know one person's been asking stuff about clans and clan systems in chat a bunch of times.
Clans?
Yeah, clans in general. So, like,
clans.
Two things that popped up in chat right now are, one, will there be a clan alliance system? And then two would be, do we have plans or can we make the suggestion for adding, like, a permission system? Like, kind of like in a lot of games that feature, like, clan systems and stuff like that, like members would have very basic access. And
more options for configuring your clans however you want.
Yeah, to organize.
We have talked about that. We have talked about how many ranks is a good number of ranks to have. Uh-huh. We should let them make however many ranks they want. We are working on it. Alliances we have discussed as well. I don't think we have any plans right now to work on alliances, but it might well be that when we look at the clan stuff, that comes up as something that we should do, right?
Okay.
And of course we'll be looking at what people do. We watch the game all the time. We watch people playing the game all the time, every day. So look at what people say in the forums and what kind of things people need for these systems, right? Right now it's all pretty bare bones on the clan side of things.
Uh-huh.
The ranks are fixed, you cannot change them, right? And the permissions are also fixed, they work in a specific way. But we are going to be adding some options for example, an option we're adding soon is the ability to make all your boxes be accessible by everybody.
Oh.
As a server set, right? So you want to make a server where everyone can just access the stuff in your box by touching it, you can do that, right? Later on, we might add stuff like, hey, only you have this rack, you can access the stuff in the box. But we're working on this, trying to improve the clan system too.
Well, yeah, thank you. Let's see, sorry. Let me give you a shout out for that name. Zion Matrix with an extra X. Thank you for your question in chat. I appreciate it. When can we see Quivers?
That's a good question. We were going to have Quivers.
Okay.
Where you would actually see the arrows that you would shoot.
Okay.
With models and everything hanging from the bodies and stuff, we decided to move away from that because it just kind of complicated the character setup. And it was unnecessary at that stage in the project, right? Maybe we'll have quivers in the future. I don't know. I cannot promise anything.
Sure. It popped up and I thought it was a good question.
We talk a lot about the role-play elements of the game and the visuals of your character and how to make your character look different and unique and how to make your character look real as well. So quivers are definitely one of those aspects, so we might revisit them, but cannot promise anything.
Right on.
All right.
Cool. Well, I think go ahead and close the questions for now. Thank you for that. We'll be back tomorrow. We might have you, if you are willing, you might have bombard you with some
of
more
course,
questions.
Of course, you're bringing
we'll
in.
But
I love this thing.
That's all the time we have now for questions right now. We're going to be wrapping things up in just a few minutes right now. Thank you all so much for your questions. I'm sorry we couldn't get to all of them. Promise to do better next time, and then I also do apologize for apparently I put the wrong times in on the Steam thread that I put in there, so I do really I am really sorry about that, losing my mind right now, but we'll get it right. So what I can say right now is that we are cooking up, or we're looking to cook up a like another like big like like a fixed patch. I think that's going to be on Test Live. If you're not familiar with Test Live, you can go check the Steam forums under the tech section, I believe. Yeah, one sec. Under the tech section for information on how to get onto the Test Live branch. Oh, no, there's an entire... That's right. There's a Test Live feedback sub-forum on the Steam forums where you can then read about how to access the Test Live environment for when we do push new content patches up there, do a little bit of stress testing, make sure that there's no, like, massive issues that we were going to be able to cache because we have a somewhat controlled environment.
So give us feedback in general, what the changes in common.
Give us your feedback, let us know, help us along early access, make this the best game we possibly can. So we're going to be using that a lot more in the future, so please jump on that when you can. We'll make announcements about it when it's up. I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up with one more raffle. Now, this raffle will include the Barbarian Edition as well as a mailed and signed copy of the exclusive Conan Exiles Dark Horse one-off comic. So I'm going to go start that up in just one second. Just going to reset this real quick. Reset. Reopen. And if you chat monsters would please type !! raffle in chat. It's open. Let's go. And thank you for your kind words. The Bad Magic, most fun EA game I've played in a long while. Thanks for the continued work. We are doing our darndest to make this happen. Yep. And we are pulling some crazy long hours to make sure that these things happen. And so first of all, thank you for all the hard work.
Let's see how long my voice lasts.
For all the people over at the Funcom Studios, both in North Carolina and Norway, thank you for everything that you're doing right now, pulling all those crazy hours and making sure the game's as best as possible. And of course, thank you to the players. We can't do this without you guys.
But we do this for you guys.
Yeah, early access is a really important time right now where we are trying to work with you guys as best as possible to make the game, realize the potential of the game as best as possible. And yes, you are more than welcome to take that with you if you'd like. Yeah, those are all free. Yeah.
Go for it.
Okay, yeah. Hello.
Get more.
Yeah, you want to come on camera real quick? Sure. What's up, man? How's it going? Not much. I don't know if anyone can hear you right now. Okay. It'll just be like 2 seconds. Sorry. There you go. All right, cool. Oscar, thank you so much, man. I appreciate it. So, hey, what's your name, man? You can just speak into that if you want.
You know who I am.
Wait.
Do you not recognize me? I played with the game. Oh, sorry.
Wait, what?
Huh?
What's going on? Oops. Do I?
Yeah, I'm from Raleigh. I remember.
Oh.
Oh, whoops. Hey, hello?
I feel like a jerk. Wait, what?
Yeah. Oh, whoops. Oh, shoot.
No, you're fine. You're fine.
Oh, should I?
Say hello. Say hello to the stream real quick. This is our little passerby. That's our webcam right now. This is a live stream from the PAX East show floor. Wait, so I feel like a huge jackass now. Wait, what? Are you on? Hold on. Move a little up toward me. Sorry. I feel like a jerk. Wait, what? Where? From where?
From the game jam and the drink up.
Oh my god!
Yeah. Hey.
And you at UNC and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Hey.
Hey.
What's up, dude?
You're Andy, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I am Brandon. I just thought I would.
Hey, Brandon, what's up? Well, this is a guy I've run into before when I was in North Carolina. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. I feel like a dick.
No, it's totally cool. That's why I was saying
I dropped this. I don't know if you can hear me now. I'm sorry.
Oops.
I'm going to run this raffle real quick. Sorry. Hey, man, you been doing all right?
Yeah, I've been doing well. So what's going on over here anyway?
No, we're just doing a little. We're actually just wrapping up our live stream right now for Conan Exiles, but I figured I'd get a passerby on camera just really quick just to hang out.
Well, awesome.
See what's up.
I am a passerby.
How's PAX going for you today so far, man?
It's going really well. Good. Yeah, I've seen a lot of cool games. I came by and I was going to check out Conan Exiles because I knew that you guys were.
Right. Yeah.
I thought I'd check it out.
Oh, that's so cool.
I played Lawbreakers, another local studio.
Yeah.
That was an awesome game.
Cool.
I had a good time. So, yeah, I've done a lot of cool stuff.
Well, sweet, man. Holy shit. Yeah, as soon as we're wrapped up with you, I'd love to talk with you a little bit more. But, yeah, just give me 2 seconds. But, yeah, thanks for jumping on, man. Appreciate it. Yeah, we'll talk more in a little bit. Thanks, man. So, congratulations to Vaz on winning a Barbarian Edition key. I'm sorry, Ian.
I don't know, Randy.
Let me get out of the way for you. Well, yeah, you've won yourself a copy of the Barbarian Edition of Conan Exiles, as well as a signed copy of the Conan Exiles Dark Horse Special Edition one-off. I'm going to PM you on Twitch. We're going to need your email address, as well as, if you're comfortable with it, we need your mailing address so we can go ahead and ship this off to you. So congratulations, my man.
It's really awesome. It's really awesome. I just slid right in. I didn't slide into your DMs.
Phrasing.
I didn't slide into your DMs, but I slid into the stream, I guess. I don't know. Did it go well?
That's what's up.
Did it go well?
It's still going.
Awesome.
So that about wraps it up for today's show. Happy Friday, everyone. Thank you all for tuning in.
And thank you, everyone on the show floor, for joining us here today and listening to my now
I think
breaking
we're
going
to
voice.
We're gonna have to speak louder for the next one, I think, for the people on the show floor to hear us.
My voice
we're gonna have
is
to
dying.
Do, we're going to do with, we're gonna have to do what the British guy across the way does, and that's just like grab a microphone and shout into it.
Can do.
I mean, all it right. could work.
Sure.
Sure.
All right. We're going to wrap this up. Congrats, Faz. I'm going to PM you on Twitch. We'll answer questions when we can. We'll see you on the forums. We'll see you on Reddit. We will see you in chat. We will see you tomorrow.
Yes. 2:30.
2:30.
Eastern Standard Time.
Eastern Standard Time. I goofed and I made the wrong time on Steam, but it's okay.
It's going to be lit.
It's going to be amazing.
Hopefully.
Thank you all
for
joining us. All right, please, have an excellent
We wouldn't
weekend.
Be nothing if it wasn't for viewers like you.
We wouldn't be nothing? Oh, yeah, I guess that's technically right.
We would be nothing. We wouldn't be anything. Fuck. Just shut it off. My brain doesn't
hook.
Work.
Get the hook. All right.
All right. Oh, yeah, it's on my... There it is.
You got the keys, my
I
man.
I got the keys.
Let's do this.
I got the keys. I'm going to push the button.
Yes.
Pushing the button.